With film going straight to streaming, it's easy to miss many of the new releases coming out. When no studio or streaming service will release a film at all, however, the movie many times is lost and long forgotten. So it might have been the case for the film Run, Hide, Fight, a small indie flick that premiered at the Venice Film Festival. Controversial to say the least due to the film's subject matter of a school shooting, no one would distribute the film until conservative media outlet The Daily Wire purchased the film rights to distribute it. But does the film deserve to be shunted? Does it push any political agenda, and is it truly a film whose subject matter is best left unseen? Starring Isabel May as Zoe Hull, a high school teenager being raised by her ex-military father, Todd, played by Thomas Jane, Run, Hide, Fight tells a horrific story of a group of outcast and misfit students at Zoe's school who enact a school shooting and hold several students hostage in the cafeteria. The story follows Zoe as she does her best to survive, help others escape, and takes the shooters head on. Snidely dubbed Die Hard, set to a school shooting by critics and trashed for being tasteless, most critics that have panned the film have done so in the belief that it is either disgustingly trying to profiteer off of a serious tragedy that has happened in America, or else beliefs that the film glorifies such shootings and will only encourage others to mimic it. This is tantamount to claiming violent video games or film beget more violence, an argument that is worth having for sure, but how can you raise the debate if you quickly blacklist the narrative? Run, Hide, Fight is not a tasteless film. It does depict scenes that made me sick to my stomach, however, and this is because the film does display the truth of the situation. But the movie constantly discourages and discredits those who perform such a heinous act. The movie's message is what's most important, showcasing how systems put in place to protect us can often falter and how massive amounts of red tape can prevent others from acting in time to make a difference. The movie showcases reality and promotes its heroine as a force willing to act and stand up for what is right. Being distributed by an openly conservative outlet will immediately be a turnoff for many, but whether it's despite of its more conservative ideas or because of them doesn't matter. The film is in no way a bad movie. This is not to say it doesn't come with faults. Some gaps in believability exist in the narrative, such as a school cafeteria full of students unsupervised, but when it comes to the important plot points, such as the failure of those in charge to act due to the previously mentioned red tape, the film is spot-on accurate. Other instances, such as cliched or campy camera work and a hit-or-miss performance from Thomas Jane, are definite flaws in the film. Ultimately, however, the movie is an entertaining and well-made film of good versus evil, with good prevailing, and to find fault in that message is rather silly. Yes, the film is not for everyone, the subject matter is a tough one and may be too hard to watch for some audiences, and being R-rated, it is not intended to be seen by certain audiences. But these things do not inherently make the film bad. Likewise, concerns of it being tasteless or glorifying school shootings I find are unfounded. The movie offers up enough ideas and commentary on the subject to have a reason for existing, and it's these themes people should seize on to hopefully open up a dialogue in which we can all strive to prevent such events from happening. I give Run, Hide, Fight 3 out of 4 stars.